In this video, I'm going to demonstrate Shakefree. First, open your project in Premiere, then go to Window, Extensions, and click Shakefree. It'll open as a floating panel. Grab it by the top part and put it onto an existing panel like this. Now I have two sequences here of footage from a documentary that I filmed. One cam raw and two cams synced. So to add them to the queue, make the sequence active in the timeline, come over to the plugin and hit the plus. Do the same here. So you can see that stable is selected by default because that's what you're going to want to see for sure. Some people will want to see the shake as a separate sequence. I do, so I'm going to select them. Now for ripple delete, if I double click here, it'll open up the sequence. And if we look at it, if a shake is removed, I'm going to want that gap closed. So for this, that's what a ripple delete is. It closes the gap. For a two cam sequence, if there's a shake that's removed, I want to keep the clips in place because this is synced. I don't want it to fall out of sync. So I'm going to keep this unselected. When ready, press play. Now this text here is going to show you the progress. The speed of processing is determined by two factors. One is your computer speed, and the second is if you've already done this processing. If you've already done it, it'll go much, much faster. Okay, all done. Now you'll see an import dialog, which just means the sequences are being imported. Now when the import is done, you might see some clips in the main bin. Drag them into the Shakefree folder. This was created by Shakefree. Inside of it, you'll now see the results. So this is the shake and stable from one cam, the shake and the stable from two cam. Let's look at one cam first, and let's look at the shake. There's the next clip. And here, you see how it starts stable? What we do is we always take the start point of the shake and we add a little bit of padding, and that just ensures that the edits are going to be clean. Okay, we'll go to the next one. So you see this one again started stable for a couple frames and then it became shaky. And again, that just ensures a clean edit. So that was the shake. Now let's take a look at the stable results. Not bad. Okay, so let's take a look at the two cam results now. And the first thing you'll notice is that they stayed in sync. Everything stayed in its place, which is very important when you're editing. So let's take a look at the shakes. Okay. Okay. Okay, that was pretty good. Let's now take a look at the stable. So what you saw there at the beginning, that's actually not a shake. That's what's called a whip pan. And whip pans, we actually allow to the stable footage because usually they're intentional. Sometimes they're not, but by default, we're going to assume they are. That's just the safer route to take. Okay, so that was good for stable. Here's another stable. Nice dolly shot. That was just over 2 seconds. That's kind of our minimum length for what we allow through for stable. And there you saw another whip pan, which we do allow through. Let's take a peek over here. So this is stable. Good, that was a smooth shot. So you'll notice there's a little bit of shake and a little bit of erraticness to these shots, but not too much. And what we've done is we've established a threshold so that a little bit of shake gets through, but not the severe shake. Thanks so much for watching. Hopefully this helps and gives you more time to be creative.